Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and for today's video I'm going to be showing you guys how to apply liquid eyeliner. I know that sounds a little bit scary if you are new at it or just don't know how to do it or just need to get a little bit more oomph behind yourself to achieve it. So I'm going to show you guys a few different ways of how to get the perfect eyeliner look that will make such a dramatic difference in your eye. Then just keep watching. Okay, before we start off, I'm just gonna let you know that my eyebrows are a little bit cray cray right now. You can obviously tell which one is better. I have no clue what is going on with this brow, but it's nothing like this other brow. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I need to get in to get my eyebrows waxed, but it's been a hot minute for all of us, so as soon as they get back in, I'm gonna get this fixed. Okay, quit talking and get to it. So, I zoomed in so that way you guys can see up close how to do my my eyeliner. Can't talk right now. Okay, so I do not do my eyelashes before I apply mascara. What am I talking about? Okay, so I do my eyeliner before I apply mascara. The reason being because after my mascara is already applied, it is very difficult to try to move your lashes or just try to like get around them and get really tight to the lash line. I can't do that. I'm not that talented. I mean, I probably could do that, but we're not gonna do that. We're gonna do it the right way today. I'm just taking my Stilla Stay All Day Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner, and this is the Intense Black shade. I used to use the Kat Von D Tattoo one, but after a little while of using it, say like a month of using it, the tip of it would dry out and I wouldn't be able to use it anymore. And it's pretty expensive, so I decided to try something new. I still love that Kat Von D Tattoo Liquid Eyeliner. But I just don't like the fact that they all dry out. I have had so many of them and they all dry out. So I'm trying a new one. I've been using this one for probably 4 months. I love the applicator tip on it. It's very precise and very thin towards the end of it. It's kind of like a marker basically, and I just love how thin it is, and I love that it's all stuck together. I can't think of the appropriate word to describe it, but they are all together. It's not like a brush with many different bristles attached to it. It's all one thing, if you get what I'm saying. My first way I'm going to show you is my number one way. This is how I always, always do it. I just find that this technique works best for me, but it might not work best for you, so I'm going to show you another way of how to do it as well. Alright, so the first step that I do, and I have my mirror because we're touching the eyeball, I need to get in pretty close. So I'm going to be looking down while I do this. So what I do is start at the very inner corner of my eye and just lightly go out with it. I don't know if I can talk throughout this, but I'm going to try to explain what I'm doing. You just want to stay very close to the eyelashes. Now I always take it and match it up with the tip of my nose to make it a straight line. And I just start drawing. So I've started a small line. Then I'm going to just connect it. And I'm going to bring it in. And then I just kind of lightly bring it out a little bit more and fill it all in. Then, once I have the outer edge done, I'm going to kind of fill it in a little bit more. Just like that. And the whole time when I'm doing this, I'm most likely like touching my eyelashes, so that's why I don't like to apply mascara and then put on my liquid eyeliner. I like to do before, that way I can just see everything very clearly. So here's the first eye done. This is how I do it. Just start from the inner edge, work my way out, and then I match it up and just kind of stamp it or just drag down, and then I fill it all in. That's just what works for me. That's another reason why I love this type of brush, because it's very stiff, but it's also flexible. Kind of hard to explain, but it's stiff enough to where you can draw your line and it's not going to smear or budge or, you know, move anywhere else. It's going to go exactly where you want it to go. So there is one finish. That's how I like mine. Not very dramatic, just kind of simple and cute looking. That's what I did for this one. Okay, so I'm gonna go to my other eye. Okay, for this one, you can pull on your eye, which I don't really like to do that. I don't like to do that to my skin, but I'm gonna show you how to do it. So I'm gonna start from the inner corner, no matter what. I always do that. I got the inner corner and I'm pretty much on the outer edge now. And now is where I'm gonna pull and kind of draw a line. So I'm gonna pull and just kind of line it up and draw it in. That's so much simpler. I don't know why I don't do that. Then I'm going to, I'm sorry guys, I'm probably cutting you off. Okay. Can you see? Alright. I'm just going to make that tip a little bit sharper. Start drawing it in. Here is my left eye. All I did was start from the inner corner, come out halfway, pull out and just go in like that and then fill it all in, and then I just like kind of stamp to make that sharp edge. I got the word. These little things to me are like little fibers that are all knitted together and makes it stiff and very precise. That's the word I'm looking for. Little fibers. I don't know. That's my word that I'm using. Okay. So as you can see, this eye is a little bit different than this eye. It's because we went in with two different techniques. Another trick is to take like the end of a makeup remover wipe and just like fold up in your finger and go along to make it kind of sharp and perfect. So that's another trick that you can do. Or another thing that you could even do is use scotch tape. Take a piece off of it, stick it on the back of your hand a few times so that way it's not sticking so harshly on your face, and match it up right here and draw your line. So three ways to do it. I hope that helped you guys, and now you know how to do eyeliner if you didn't know before, or if you are one of those girls or guys who struggles with applying eyeliner. I have helped so many of my friends achieve the eyeliner look that they want, and I just wanted to share it with you guys as well. Anybody out there that's looking for a way to create the perfect eyeliner look, the cat eye, the cute flirty eye, the harsh, bold, everything eye, this is how you can achieve it, three different ways. And let me just finish off by putting on some mascara so that way I don't look so bleh. I know that I've been quiet for this because I'm trying to concentrate. Do you guys see how long my eyelashes are? This is why I cannot live without mascara. Like, if there's one thing that I have to apply that I cannot not go out with, it's mascara, because look at the difference between this eye and this eye. Like, totally different. It's crazy. If you guys watch my Amazon haul, in there I talk about a product that works so good that I've been using on my eyelashes to help with hair, skin, and nail growth, all that stuff. I've been using it for maybe about 4 weeks now, 3 to 4 weeks, and I swear my eyelashes were not this long before then. I don't even feel like I need to put fake eyelashes on. I don't even feel like I need that. So, like, I think it's working for me. I think the product that I am using is working for my eyelashes, because they have never been this full and voluminous. And obviously, I know that this helps with lengthening and volumizing, but it's not just this BADGal that's working for me. It's something else that I'm using. So I will put that video in the description box below if you haven't seen it, because we got some really good products in there and just items that I generally love. But I'm gonna quit rambling, because this video was just about how to apply eyeliner, and we're talking about eyelashes now. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching all the different ways to apply eyeliner. Like I said, the first way that I applied it is just my own personal preference of how to do it. That's just how I taught myself years and years ago, and that's just what works for me. So it's not going to work for everybody, and that is okay. If you didn't like the first way how I did it, try the second or the third way. It will all work, and practice makes perfect. So practice multiple times. Like, practice, practice, practice. I cannot say that enough. So that being said, I'm gonna end this video. If you liked this video, please do the 4 things for me. Like, comment, subscribe, and ring that notification bell to see when my next video is gonna be up. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.